So what we're going to do, Liliana, we're just going to go ahead and pray.
Okay. Yeah.
And you know what I want us this time, what I want us to pray about is for the Lord to do His wonderful work in the minds and hearts of His children, because mm-hmm. what is happening, His children are coexisting with demons, and they are pleased to coexist. The word coexist means to exist at the same time or in the same place, or in the same place. And God is not going to share us with no demon. His desire is to have all of us and not just some of us. But God's children are like, they are willing to they don't realize they are coexisting with demons. To them, they are not. But if they have never been delivered after they've given their life to Jesus Christ, where God's anointed appointed servant has commanded those spirits to come out of the soul realm, which is the mind, the will, and the emotions and body, that means that God's child is coexisting with demons. And his child is comfortable with that so as long as the demon does not manifest in any way. As long as they financially prospering, as long as they are not being tormented, as long as they, you know, things are going the way that they desire for them for things to go, they then are satisfied coexisting with demons. But the moment things go contrary to the way that they don't want them to go, and then they begin to realize that demons are in them, then that is the only time that they want the demons out of them, because the demons are hindering their financial blessing. And that should not be the purpose of wanting to be delivered. The purpose of wanting to be delivered is so that we can worship and serve our Heavenly Father in spirit and in truth. So let's pray that God will work in the hearts and in the mind of our brothers and sisters in Him, that they refuse in any shape, form, or fashion, as Jesus Christ did when He was tempted to coexist with Satan in the wilderness, mm-hmm. when Satan showed Him the kingdom of the world and told Jesus if He would bow down to Him, all of that would be His. And Jesus said no. Jesus refused to coexist with devils. So therefore, we as God's children, we should also refuse to coexist. So we're going to pray that our Heavenly Father do whatever it takes to bring His child in correction, in submission to His word, so that they can always have that hunger and thirst after God's right standing, after God's righteousness, which is His right standing. Okay, so that's going to be our prayer for today. Okay. So, Father, in Jesus' name, we want to thank You, Father, for this opportunity to come and gather. You said where there are two or three or more gathered together in Your Son's name, You are with us. And whatever we bind and loose on this earth, You will bind and loose in the heaven. Father, I thank You, Father, for giving us a hunger and a thirst for Your righteousness, for being in right standing with You, Father, no matter what may happen to us, no matter what going on in our life. We hunger, we thirst after Your righteousness, Father. And Father, the only way you can do that, that you must put that hunger, you must put that thirst on the inside of us, Father. Father, don't let us get complacent, all because we are financially blessed. We are financially stable. Father, there's more to life than just putting raiment on our body, to just having material things. There's more to life than that, Father. But You have commanded us to seek Your kingdom and Your righteousness and whatever else we need on this earth to survive. You supplies those knees, Father. But Father, I ask you, Father, just to give us that hunger and thirst. Lord, put in our hearts and mind that we refuse, Father, as Jesus Christ refuse the devil's bargain.
Help us, Father, to refuse
whatever bargain the devil issues out to us. Help us to reject it, Father.
Because, Father, we refuse to
coexist with demons, with devils, because it's not your will
to
have some of us, and then not all of us. It's not your will to reside in one compartment in our body, and the devil reside in another compartment. That is not your will, Father. And I thank you, Father, that Jesus was born upon this world.
You destroyed
that very work of the devil, the
coexistence
of demons within people. Jesus destroyed the devil's work, Father, in Jesus' mighty name. And Father, we receive that glorious work that Jesus done on the cross, for our behalf. We praise you and thank you, Father, for a work well done in Jesus Christ. Jesus did not fail as a human being coming into this world, as a man born through, as a little boy, baby boy, born through the virgin of a woman.
That you reveal, Lord, what is wrong with people.
Lived upon this land 33 and a half years, and he did not fail. And we thank you, Father, that through him is victory.
That our prayers,
through Jesus Christ, through his shed blood, there is victory. And we walk in his victory, Father. And help us to know, Father, that our victory is in him, Father.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Father, we just thank you. We thank you, Father, for increasing our trust, our faith in your word, in Jesus' completed word. For Jesus' last words on this earth, he said, it is finished, it's done. But that meant that Jesus did not fail. He did not fall as a man. He did not fail. He was successful in every area that you had ordained him to be successful in. Jesus Christ as a man was successful. And Father, we walk in Jesus' success this day by his Spirit. We thank you for the power, your power, who is the Holy Spirit. Not just reside, he resides in us. He resides in our mind, our will, our emotions, our body. He dictates it and tells us and shows us what we
everybody that needs deliverance.
We get our instructions and command from him and him alone, Father. We thank you for empower us with his strength, with him, Father. Letting his power and his anointing come upon us only for a service for our Lord and Jesus Christ. Father, we thank you. Father, we thank you, Father. Father, we know if we allow ourselves to coexist with devils, the Holy Spirit cannot have his way in us, Father, because he refused to coexist with devils, Father. And we also refuse to coexist with devils. Father, we thank you for opening up the blinded eyes of your children. Open up the blinded eyes. Even those who are listening live and also to the archives, open up their blind eyes, their deaf ears, to let them hear what the Spirit of God is saying to his church, Father. Because, Father, one day he is coming. You are coming, Father. You are coming. Jesus coming back here one day to gather his own. And, Father, we want to be included in that number, Father. But in the meantime, Father, while on this earth, we thank you for empowering us with your strength, with your power, in Jesus' mighty name. We give you all the praise and we give you all the glory, Father. Father, we thank you, Father. Father, we really thank you for small beginning, because it's in the small beginning we get to know you. We get to know who you is. In the small beginning, you make yourself known unto us, Father. In small beginning, Father, you empower us with your Spirit. You give us a zeal to do your work, Father. You empower us to do that work, Father. And we say thank you, Father. Father, I ask you to remember Rita, who also is praying along with us. Won't able to connect with us on this line, but I know she is praying with us, and I thank you, Father, that you too are hearing her prayer, and I thank you for her faithfulness, Father, in coming in every week trying to join in, but the enemy is hindering her from coming on. I thank you, Father, that her faith is strong in you. Will not and shall not and cannot give up, but to crying, Father. And Father, we pray
in your
and thank you for her, Father. And I ask you to continue to strengthen her. Give her strength right now. Give her strength in those weak areas, Father. Give her strength in those areas, Father. And thank you for sustaining and keeping her with women by your spirit, Father. Empower her, Father, with your spirit.
We peel it right now. Anybody that is a deliverance in your life is broken. Any chain, any generational curse, break him right now.
But not just hearing us, but Father, for also doing as we have requested in your word to do, Father. And we thank you this day for your strength in Jesus' mighty name. Amen, amen, amen. Praise God, praise God. Thank you. Rita won't able to connect with us, but she's still on the line, and the Lord let me know that she's still praying. So Rita, I thank you. Continue to try to come on, and eventually you will come on. A lot of times the Lord will test us to see if we will continue to try to do a thing when there are obstacles in our way, but to show God that we really is pressing after him, whatever obstacle may be in our way, we keep pressing because we're so determined to get to Jesus, so determined to get to Jesus, and doing by that termination, Rita, God will allow you to get to him. So you keep trying, and you will eventually get on. So I would advise you, if you do have the Android, again, go to the website and try downloading the app, the mobile app on the Android, and connect that way, okay? And we'll see. So I'm going to notify Zeno Live and let them know what the problems that I had today. I want to continue to, you know, give them a chance because, like I said, this program is new. It's in beta. It's a test. So anytime we run into problems, then we must notify them so that they can correct the problem. So I'm not complaining because they don't charge. It's a free service. So I am not complaining. So I praise God for their generosity in giving us this free service. So, Liliana, thank you for tuning in and being faithful to God. And, dear heart, if you're listening, we have morning prayer every Tuesday and Thursday at 8 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. Also on Wednesdays, we have a live call-in deliverance session. And that's Wednesdays at 2 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. So feel free to go to our website, thechildrensmite.org, and click on Media Radio 24/7, Deliverance Radio, and the instructions in how to tune in